Beloved in Christ, as we await the great festival of Christmas, let us prepare ourselves so that we may be shown its true meaning. Let us hear, in lessons from Holy Scripture, how the prophets of Israel foretold that God would visit and redeem his waiting people. Let us rejoice in our carols and hymns that the good purpose of God is being mightily fulfilled. Let us celebrate the promise that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will bring all people and all things into the glory of God's eternal kingdom. The blind receive sight, and the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear. The dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. But first, let us pray. For the world which God so loves, for those who have not heard the good news of God, or who do not believe it, for those who walk in darkness and the shadow of death, and for the church in this place and everywhere, that it may be freed from all evil and fear, and may in pure joy lift up the light of the love of God. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer to God in the words which Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
God announces in the Garden of Eden that the seed of woman shall bruise the serpent's head. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden. And I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree, whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat? And the man said, The woman whom thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Thanks be to God.
The Lord promises Cyrus, salvation shall come to the ends of the earth. For the sake of my servant Jacob and Israel, my chosen, I call you by your name, I surname you, though you don't know me. I am the Lord, there is no other. Besides me, there is no God. I arm you, though you do not know me, so that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west that there is no one besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. I form light and create darkness. I make weal and create woe. I, the Lord, do all these things. Shower, O heavens, from above, and let the skies rain down righteousness. Let the earth open that salvation may spring up, and let it cause righteousness to sprout up also. I, the Lord, have created it. Thanks be to God.
A reading from Zechariah. Up, up, flee from the land of the north, says the Lord, for I have spread you abroad like the four winds of heaven, says the Lord. Up, escape to Zion, you that live with daughter Babylon, for thus said the Lord of hosts, after his glory sent me, regarding the nations that plundered you, truly one who touches you touches the apple of my eye. See now, I am going to raise my hand against them, and they shall become plunder for their own slaves. Then you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me. Sing and rejoice, O daughter Zion, for too I will come and dwell in your midst, says the Lord. Many nations shall join themselves to the Lord on that day, and shall be my people, and I will dwell in your midst. And you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will inherit Judah as his portion of the Holy Land, and I will again choose Jerusalem. Be silent, all people, before the Lord, for he has roused himself from his holy dwelling. Thanks be to God.
The parable of the wise and foolish virgins. Then the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them. But the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight, there was a shout. "Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all of those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise replied, "No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet. And the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he replied, "Truly, I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." Thanks be to God.
The one who is to rule Israel will be born in the village of Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrath, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel, and he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The prophet foretells the glory of the kingdom of God. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly. And rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it. The majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. And then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. Thanks be to God.
Oh,
the angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said, Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
the cathedral. I'm Dean Owens. It's a blessing to have you with us on this first Sunday of Advent. One note, as you leave, there'll be baskets that if you wish to make a donation, we welcome anything you're able to offer. There'll be baskets on the way out. Luke may or may not be holding it as you walk past him. I invite you, if you offer a check, to make it out to Music and Art at Trinity. And of course, you can also make a donation online at any time. If you'd like to learn more about Trinity Cathedral or about Music and Art, you'll see along many of the base of many pillars information on Trinity. Of course, I invite you to explore our website to see all the services that we'll be offering throughout Advent and Christmas Eve and Christmas. Again, welcome.
Thank you.
wait for thy loving kindness, O Lord. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light. Now, in the time of this mortal life, in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, now and forever. Amen. Open wide, O Lord, the gates of heaven, and visit thy people in peace. Send forth thy Spirit from on high, that their hearts may be uplifted unto thee. O Lord, who for our sake wast of a virgin born, make holy thy people and bless thine heritage. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and abide with you forever. Amen.